Hi there. Welcome back to the ANCA Academy. On today's episode, we're going to be talking about the first step to grinding any tool, and that's wheel pack setup. I'll be talking about some of the more commonly used grinding wheels, how we build a wheel pack, and then finally, how we qualify the wheel pack on the machine using the wheel editor application. So let's get into it. Before we get started building our wheel pack, I just wanted to introduce the wheels we'll be using in our wheel pack. Now, these wheels come in different shapes and sizes and have different designations based on the FIPA standard. So the one I'm holding right now is a 1A1. This has a square profile and will be usually used for fluting. The next wheel in our wheel pack is this 1V1 wheel with the periphery angled at 45 degrees. This we'll be using for gashing. The final wheel in our wheel pack is this 11A2 wheel, or a cup wheel, and this will be used for OD grinding. The other important characteristic of these wheels is the grit type and size. In this case, all these wheels are D64, meaning they're diamond abrasive, and the average grit size is 64 micron in diameter. The next part of the wheel pack assembly we'll talk about is the wheel arbor itself. Now, the different ANCA machine platforms use different wheel arbors. The FX uses the HSK 40F taper, which I'm holding here. The MX uses a wheel arbor with an HSK 50F taper. And both of these come in a range of diameters. There's 20 millimeters, 31.75 millimeters, or 1¼ inch, and 32 millimeter. The TX machine is a little bit different. It uses the big plus spindle system. So the arbors look like this with a taper. And just like the other two, they come in a range of diameters from 20 millimeters all the way up to 3 inch. Now, all of these arbors can be ordered in different lengths depending on the number of grinding wheels and can accommodate anywhere from one up to a maximum of 4 wheels per arbor. Let's go through the rest of the parts and tools we'll need to build this wheel pack. We have the grinding wheels and the wheel arbor, which we've already discussed, but we'll also need some spacers and a lock nut and washer to keep it all together. As far as the tools go, we'll be needing a spanner here and a rubber mallet, which really helps to make sure that it's fully tight, as well as this setup jig here. We also have a coolant manifold over here, and I'll be explaining the setup of that later as well. And finally, it's really important to keep things clean during the assembly of a wheel pack, so we have some lint-free paper here too. Okay, now that everything's laid out, it's time we built the wheel pack. We'll start by taking the wheel arbor and put it in the wheel pack setup jig. As I mentioned earlier, it's really important that we keep everything nice and clean when we're building a wheel pack. So we'll give this arbor a quick wipe with our cloth. Next, we'll put a single spacer on, again, making sure that it's nice and clean. After this, our 1A1 wheel. Give the bore a quick wipe. Now, when we fit a wheel, we never want to force it. It should slide on nicely by itself. Maybe you need to give it a little bit of a rotation, but make sure you never force it because they will jam. After this, we'll put on some of these spacers here. Again, making sure they're nice and clean. Followed by the 1V1 wheel. Now, after this, one more spacer. And finally, the cut wheel. You'll notice that these wheels just slide on. You really don't need to force them. Finally, there's one more spacer just to make sure that the lock nut is in the correct position. So we'll slide that on. And finally, the washer. And you'll notice it has small tangs on it. So make sure you align those with the slots in the wheel arbor. And then finally, the lock nut. So we'll just nip this up finger tight before we take it over to the Zoller to check the run out. One final thing. I know where all the wheels need to be here because I've already done a simulation of the tool I plan to grind. The positions of the wheels will depend on the tool geometry, what operations we're grinding. So it's important you do a simulation first before we build the wheel pack. All right, so let's take this over to the Zoller to check the run out. Now I'm here with our wheel pack, tightened finger tight, and I'm gonna put it on our measurement machine here and measure the run out of each of the three wheels, just to see that they're acceptable before I fully tighten the nut on the jig. So we've mounted the wheel pack in the presetter, and all we're gonna do is measure the run out of each wheel, looking at the periphery and the front face. We're not doing any measurement here, we're purely looking. So, drive to the back face and periphery. Position the crosshairs like so. And then we just wanna rotate the wheel. And as we can see, there's very little run out there. So that's probably considered acceptable. Then we move to the other face. And again, check. We can see that there's very little run out there. Moving to the next wheel. We can do the same thing. See, there's a little bit more run out there, but still acceptable. Finally, we'll go to the cut wheel, and we can see here that that's running very true. Now we've seen here that the run out on all these wheels were acceptable. That's probably because we made sure that all our spaces were clean, our wheel arbor was clean, and our wheels are in good condition. If you do the run out check and you see that there's a lot of front face run out, or even a little bit of periphery run out, a good idea is to check the cleanliness of all your spaces, make sure they're burr free, make sure the wheels are in good condition, and reassemble. Now that we've made sure that the wheel run out is acceptable, we're gonna take the wheel pack back to the setup jig and fully tighten the lock nut. Now this lock nut's already finger tight, but to fully tighten it, we'll need this spanner here and a rubber mallet. A few sharp strikes with the rubber mallet should fully tighten the lock nut. So there we have it, fully built wheel pack. Now we'll take it back to the Zoller for measurement. So bring the wheel pack in, lock it up. Now the important dimensions here are from this shoulder here to the back face of the 1A1, the front face of the 1A1, back and front of the 1V1, and the front of the 11A2. Now also, the diameters of the periphery of each wheel are important, and the toroid radius of the edge that's being used. So, here we go. Now that we've completed our wheel pack measurement, we'll take it back to the setup jig and set up our coolant manifold. As you can see here, I've got an MX coolant manifold with some adjustable nozzles pre-fitted. So this coolant manifold also sits in the setup jig, like so. And the main aim here is to just roughly position these nozzles so that they're shooting approximately at the grind point of each wheel. And we'll do the fine tuning when we're on the machine. So there we go, that looks good. Let's take it to the machine and qualify this pack. Here we are in front of the machine with our fully measured wheel pack and our roughly adjusted coolant manifold. The next step is to mount these into the spindle, and I'll show you how to do that now. To mount the wheel pack, the first step is to open the door. The Next step is to open the Wheel Exchanger application from the utility menu. And make sure the machine is in manual mode. But before we actually put this into the spindle, it's really important to make sure that the arbor taper and the spindle front face are both really clean. So we'll take a rag. Now that they're clean, we can go ahead and mount the wheel pack. Position it in the spindle and press clamp. The next step is the coolant manifold, and that's done in a very similar way. Position it like so and press clamp. And that's it, you're done. Okay, now that everything's mounted, the next step is to define the wheel pack and qualify it, and we do that inside the wheel editor. So let's launch that application now. Now that we have the wheel editor open, we need to define our wheel pack. And to do that, we'll build a pack in the software that resembles the pack that we physically built. So here we'll start with an HSK 50 arbor, and these dimensions match the arbor that we used. Now the first thing we put on our arbor when we built it was a spacer, so we'll put one of those on now. After the spacer, we have a 1A1 wheel. Now if we press OK here, it will prompt us to put in a maximum RPM. This is a safety function, so before defining any wheel, we need to put in a maximum wheel RPM. So we'll do that now. After the 1A1, another spacer, and then a 1V1 wheel. Again, making sure we put in a maximum RPM. After the 1V1, another spacer. And finally, our 11A2 cup wheel. Now you'll notice I didn't actually put in any measurement data. At this point, all we want to do is build a pack with the wheels in the correct order. So when our pack looks like this, we could go ahead and qualify it. And to do that, we go up here and press qualify, and we're going to select user input because this allows us to manually input the measurement data that we took on our Zeller machine. Before we can input any data, we need to save the wheel pack. So let's do that right now. And after this, we'll input the measurement data. After that, it will automatically mount the wheel pack to spindle one. And over here, it should say yes to qualified and yes to mounted. The final thing we'll do is to define our toroid radii on each wheel. So select the cup wheel and add the toroid radius value that we measured. Next, our 1V1. And finally, our 1A1. You'll notice now that the wheel is not qualified. So to do that, we go back to qualify and skip. And here you can see that qualified has changed to yes, and we're done. So there we have it. We've built our wheel pack, we've mounted it in the spindle, we've qualified it, and we've also mounted our roughly adjusted coolant manifold, which we'll fine tune as part of the final setup before grinding. Well, that's it for today's episode. I hope you found it useful. As always, if there's anything you'd like us to cover in future episodes, please leave it in the comments below. Thanks very much for joining us. I'll see you next time. And until then, keep grinding.